About 40% of people have anxiety about flying. Now, let's add that you or someone you're traveling with has a disability. So in this video, let's discuss how you can best prepare for a flight. Being prepared is always going to be a big part of every successful flight with someone with disabilities. So, know how to prepare. Let's break this down to before, during, and post-flight.
So let's discuss pre-flight, before the departure day. If possible, choose a short journey for the first flight. That way, everyone has a chance to get acquainted with the process. Start practicing the steps. Read a book. Watch a video. Use a social story. And you can even visit the airport. American Airlines has a travel experience program called It's Cool to Fly American Airlines. This program was first launched in 2014. It was designed to allow children with autism and other disabilities to board the company's plane. And it even taxis around the airport's runway for about 30 minutes. Also, pilots power up the engine to let them feel the roar and thrust of takeoff. You can also do a trial run through TSA security or role play the process.
Let me jump in here with two quick tips about TSA. You can call a TSA support specialist in advance. There's going to be details in our description on how to do that. Besides putting in there things about their phone number, the website, what kind of liquid you can bring on the plane, there's also going to be descriptions on what kind of equipment and things are permitted for your carry-on luggage. One great thing is that you can request the support of a specialist at the airport or in advance through the website. This specialist is going to be trained to help you or the one in your care through security checkpoints. Plus, those with disabilities can be screened with the person they're traveling with instead of being separated. Also, TSA pre-check lines are much shorter on their wait times. Travelers who are 12 years old or younger or 75 or older can also leave on their jackets and shoes when they go through the security checkpoint lines. So as you can see, there are several ways a TSA support specialist can assist you. The second thing I want to talk about is you can use a TSA disability notification card. This card helps the TSA agents better serve your family and those with disabilities. This card is a basic nonverbal way for you to be able to communicate to those at the airport, whether it's the TSA agents or those going through security lines, on how they can assist your family.
If you are traveling with more than one child, decide ahead of time who is responsible for which child during the flight. Be prepared for tantrums, hunger, boredom, games, music, entertainment, having to go to the bathroom, and ears hurting. So prepare meals and travel bags so that they have their preferred foods and comfort items. Some of the best things you can do at the airport pre-flight are notify gate attendants and ask if you are permitted to board early or last, depending on your preference. Move. Do some exercise before your flight takes off. Some airports have areas for kids to play, learn, and interact by your gate. Make sure everyone goes to the bathroom. And beforehand, discuss with your loved ones what the process of boarding the plane looks like. For example, sometimes you walk outside and get on a ramp to enter the plane. Other times, there's a tunnel that connects to the plane and you don't go outside.
All right, now let's talk about how to prepare for during the flight. Gum, sucking on hard candy, or a chew toy can be an effective way to reduce ear discomfort. Make sure on that airplane that your travel bag is stuffed. Make sure you have blankets, stuffies, entertainment options, games, food, snacks. And now let's talk about post-flight. What worked, what didn't work so well. And let's repeat the process on the things that were winners. Oh, and when you're traveling, don't forget to travel in style. Make sure you wear your LJC merch on that plane. If you don't have a shirt, you need to message us and let us know. We'll make sure you have one. We hope you feel more comfortable now that you have some ideas on how to prepare to fly.
Be sure to view our playlist of attractions and destinations, where we review locations based on the viewpoint of a family traveling with disabilities. Caregivers are the emotional, physical, and mental support for those who cannot perform in those areas on their own. we want to encourage you and let you know that you are not alone. We would love to send you a prayer cloth today to let you know that we are praying with you and we believe in you. Philippians chapter 4, verses 6 and 7 says, "Do not be anxious or worry about anything. Pray. In every situation, pray and petition. With thanksgiving, present your requests to God. God will bless you with peace that no one can completely understand. This peace will control how you think and feel when Christ is at the center of your life." We have an entire caregiver series playlist for you to learn from with our latest videos and videos from the past. So don't forget to check back for more content as we continue to add to this playlist. On this channel, Love, Joy, and Chaos, we provide content for caregivers that encourages and educates. Thank you for liking the video, sharing it, and for clicking subscribe.